Today we're about to dive into one of my favorite tricks in editing world, faking slow motion with Premiere Pro. Now we've all been there, you captured some killer footage, but maybe your camera doesn't shoot at high frame rates, or you just missed that perfect slow motion moment. Well, fear not, because with a little bit of editing magic, we can make those shots buttery smooth, like they were meant for slow motion all along.
Basically, I have two examples in here. One will be successful and one will be failure. So let's start with the successful one. So in here, if we're going to right click and go to the properties of this clip, so we're going to see that this clip is 29.97. So basically this is 30 FPS clip. And if we're going to play it back, you will see that it's a pretty much fast paced clip. So how we're going to slow-mo it? So right click, you can go to speed and duration, and you can go, let's go to 25%, press OK. And you will see that it's choppy and we're doing something wrong. So how to fix this? Right click, go to speed again, and you can see there is this time interpolation. Change this to optical flow and press OK, and you will see that it turns red. Basically, nothing has changed. And what optical flow will do? Optical flow will be used to analyze the frames of your footage, then artificially generate new frames to fill in the gaps as the content was recorded at high frame rate originally. So in order to see this smoothly, we have to render this. Just press enter in here, so Premiere will render this section for us so the playback can be smooth. So let's wait till it finish. So basically it's done, and you can see the playback, how smooth it is compared to what it was before. So basically you can see how slow and nice it is now. And for the comparison purposes, let's just drop the original clip and look at this, and then look at this. Oof, that's cool, right? Like, look at this. And then, like, it was this before. So this is basically the successful case. Okay, now I'm going to show you the case that it's not going to work. So basically, again, right click, speed duration, let's go to 25, right? And let's change the time interpolation to optical flow, press OK. And now let's view it. So in here you can see these strange artifacts. So basically what is going on? Optical flow tries to recreate those frames, those missing frames, but this background is too complex for the optical flow, and this is the case where it's not going to work. So basically you have to analyze your footage and understand if it's going to work for your specific case or not. So in this particular case, you can see these strange artifacts, and basically it means that the background is too complex and it's not going to work for this footage. And basically this is it.
Keep in mind that this is not the perfect solution, and it will not work for each and every footage the same way. If you have the option to go with 60 FPS or 120 FPS, you should do that, and you should try to get everything in camera. And this is like the backup option for you if you don't have any other way to achieve slow motion. You should go with this route. Anyways, this is it for today's tutorial. We'll catch you in the next one. Till then, stay awesome.